Oh. Please, sit down. You can tell me. We can sit down and we can talk about this. We can... Wait! Please! Can we please talk? My dad has to be so worried about me. Don't you have a father?
I don't have anyone anymore.
Please. Just let me go before he comes back.
He's not coming back.
What? Wait. You can let me go. Tell anyone what would happen. I promise I won't tell anyone.
You won't tell anyone?
I know you're afraid of him too.
You're not going to tell anyone because you're never leaving this room alive. I was never afraid of him. I loved him. I would do anything. I did anything for him. He was my masterpiece.
Tell me it's a girl.
What?
It can't be a boy. Please.
You have a son.
Be a boy. It can't be a boy.
Get it away from me.
You need to take him.
I don't want it.
But
it's gonna hurt me like they own him. I thought for sure I was having a girl.
No. You guys.
There you are. Brian's coming down to approve Clea's wardrobe. He has nixed everything I've shown him. I'm running out of options. Help.
Not bad. You know, he likes preppy in an ironic way. If you lose the belt, you should be fine. And if you let him think he came up with it, he'll love it. I'll tuck your shirt. No one can be skinnier than he is.
5 more pounds is not gonna kill him. Show me, my sweet. Now I love it. Approved.
My employer is very upset.
I'm sorry to hear that.
The order does not exist to serve your personal vendettas.
Perhaps if you'd listened when I tried to warn you.
Am I now know of the girl's existence? Plans were in place, but now she's guarded and protected. Your involvement is no longer required. We will dispose of the girl.
Good news?
Very. By tonight, the Uniter's entire support system will be eliminated.
I can't afford any mistakes.
Don't worry. There's no one more deadly than an assassin with a grudge.
Oh, sorry. I know you're busy.
It's all yours. Discuss that the next time we see each other. Assuming, of course, you come back to life.
Look at you. You're like a hairy little dog just like humping me all the time. And you hurt me all the time. And you're not right in the head. And you have a really small dick, this giant bush with this tiny, tiny dick. And half the time it doesn't even work. And it's like some little like gummy bear or something. And you're really ugly. You're really really ugly. You're like an ugly, hairy fucking Mexican, and I don't want to see you again. Ever. So fuck off.
I didn't feel anything.
That's good.
You've already thought about marrying me? You want to kiss me?
I don't like camping. It's disgusting. I feel so dirty.
Then why didn't you say so before I asked you what you wanted to do?
I don't live here. I don't know what the fuck to do.
You make the plans. You can't be so lame.
Are you sure this is the right mood?
What do you mean?
I mean, wouldn't you rather see something else? I picked this one, but you can change it. You can change it to whatever you like.
I like this one.
You do?
It's perfect.
What if I made you choose another?
You don't have to make me do anything.
All right. Supposing I asked you to choose another, what would it be?
Whatever you like the most. What is the essence? You take this one. The wives always hate me.
You sure? I think I smell beef rendang.
I'll take some to go. And if there's sticky rice.
Yeah, there's always sticky rice. What the hell, Bo?
Sorry, baby. Next time, don't get caught.
You know how this plays out. You know what happens next.
She knows, Eddie. She also knows that if I don't punish you, others will feel free to make the same mistake.
Faith in their bounty. My people have some.